everyone. I just released this new DIY macrame wall hanging pattern. This one is called Sharp Triangles and it's available at reformfibers.etsy.com. And today I'm just gonna share a few tips on things I wish I knew as I was first working on this design. And so all of the details as far as the length of the cords, the size of the rope and all that will be available in the pattern download. But just gonna share some tips. So I have a filler cord here, and what you want to do is match up the two ends, and then you're going to find your center. And you also want to find the center of your previous row, or if you're just starting out, you want to find the center of your bar. We're going to go to the middle and go down. And I like to hold the cord in my right hand and have the left hand travel to the left. And the reason we do this is so that we end up with the same amount of fringe at each end. Now in this design, you're going to skip the first working cord. So if you look here, we have all of the filler cords and then the working cords kind of get hidden behind. So this is the first cord, but we're going to skip that one and go right to the second one. So again, I have the center of my filler cord, center of the previous row, travel to the left, and then this is where the first knot is going to be tied. And we tie the first horizontal clove hitch knot. And I do have a separate video if you want to just watch that one that is specifically on the horizontal clove hitch. So it is wrapped around two times. And the first knot is always the most challenging to start. In this design, you want the rows to be nice and tight. So I do think of this kind of like molding it into place. You can kind of squeeze it into place, but you do also want to tie them nice and tight. The first knot always ends up with a little gap here, but when we get to the second cord and tie there, it allows it to fit nice and tight. Now, this is really important. As you are holding your filler cord, you do not want to hold it down because that is where your work is going to travel. So I like to hold it up tight. For your working cord, when you're tying the knot, you also do not want to pull down on it because that is where your work is going to travel. So I like to hold the filler cord up, and I also like to tie the knot up and back. So I'll show you. Again, let's see, going around counterclockwise, holding the filler cord up and tightening up and pulling towards the back. And that just allows the knot to sit nice and tight. Once you have your second cord or your second knot tied, you can kind of pull up the first one. So in this design, you skip the first cord and you also skip the last cord. And that allows for the angles to be created. I'm going to show you a quick way, or I sometimes say it's a secret way. I've been doing this for many years and it helps me to speed up my work. And it still comes out really nice. So we are going to do it with the rest of the working cords, of course, skipping the last one. So what I like to do is have my left hand fingers act as a substitute filler cord, and I wrap the working cord around my fingers like this twice. So that was my first cord. Go to the second one. And I usually do it with three or four cords at a time. I'm just going to do three. Then I transfer the cords from my left hand to my right, and then put the filler cord in the middle where my fingers were. And then I'm going to tighten up in order. So, first cord. And it does take some getting used to, you just gotta practice. But I promise it is a faster way, it gives you nice clean lines, and it just helps with productivity. Of course, it can be challenging at first. So, the this is the last quartz, so I'm just going to do it as normal. So the last tip that I have, I think, is also very helpful, in that you want your fringe to match the same angle of your knots. And so what I do is I take off the left side. We're going to pretend that this is complete. So we just have, I think it's two more rows here. So pretend that it comes down at the angle. And you're going to want your fringe angle to match this angle here. So what I do is have this line be parallel with the floor. And say I'm cutting a short fringe, let's say 2 inches or so. I'm going to cut it 2 inches all the way across, measuring down from this knot. And so then when you pick up the piece, it's going to match this angle perfectly. And that is my foolproof way of just getting it to look nice and sharp. So again, you would only go to the middle, and then you would do the same on the right side, just creating a nice sharp angle on your piece. So I hope this was helpful. Please give a thumbs up, pass on to a friend, and subscribe, all that good stuff. Thank you.